Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Stella. Welcome to Sew with Stella. So for today's tutorial, I will be learning how to make this beautiful, simple gown. It's very easy to make. You can see how beautiful it is, very free. So if you want to see how I made this dress, keep watching. And also, if you are here to subscribe, please kindly subscribe and hit the notification button for you to be notified each time I make a new upload. Don't forget to like and share with your friends. Thank you. So this is the fabric I'm going to use for the tutorial. As you can see, I've gone ahead to fold it. So I'll just go ahead and take my measurements. So this is my borderline. I've already got my borderline. So what I'm going to do next is to, this will also serve as the shoulder line. So from my shoulder to my bust is 10 inches. Then from my shoulder to my underbust is 13.5. Then from my shoulder to my waist, that's the half length, is 16.5. But I'm going to add half inch for seam allowance, what I will use to join to the down part. So it's going to be 17. So that's that. I have 13.5 and 17. I also mark it here so that I'll have a straight line. Then I'll go ahead and connect it with my ruler. So what I'm going to do next is to take my shoulder slope. My shoulder is 15. 15 divided by 2 is 7.5. 7.5 plus half inch seam allowance to join the sleeve to it. So it's going to give me 8. So I'm going to mark 8. Then remember the standard. To take our slope, I'll mark 3. Then come down here by 1. Then connect it to this, to where I marked 3. Then from my shoulder to my own upper bust, it's 36 divided by 6 is 6 plus 1.5, which is 7.5. So I can use 7.5 or I can still use 7. But take note that I'm starting here. I didn't start here. So 7.5 or 7. Let me use 7. 7. See the line clearly. So after drawing my shoulder slope, I'll connect it to this, to my upper bust. Take note that what I measured from here to here was 8. So I'm also going to mark 8 to enable me to have a straight line. You can use your office pin to, you know, hold it down so that it doesn't shift. So for the front angle, I'm going to come in by, first of all, measure this 7, half of it is 3.5, which is here. I'm going to come in by 3 quarter, which is this. Or since I'm going to leave it, let me just come in by half. I'll come in by half. Then my bust is 36. 36 divided by 4 is 9. This is 9. I'm going to have quarter inch for each allowance. 9.25, which is this. Here, so I'll just use my ruler to connect it.
please be very, very, very careful when working with this kind of fabric so that it doesn't shift. You can go ahead and use an office pin, like I said earlier, to hold it down. My bust pan is 7.5. 7.5 divided by 2 is going to give me 3.75. So 3.75 plus 0.5 is going to give me 4.25. So that's what I'm going to mark here. 4.25. I'm also going to mark it down. 4.25. I'm going to take 0.5 for my dart on each side. Then I'll go ahead and connect it. So after that, I'll just connect it to my armhole. I'm going to take note of the midpoint. It's and it's 4. I'll mark 4.5 here. And then I'll just connect it to this side. You can use your curve, your French ruler to do that, or you can just use your free hand to do it. So that's that. And then for the neckline I'll be using is the front. I'm going to make it 3. The front is going to be 3. And then, sorry, I said the depth for the front is going to be 3. And then the width is going to be, I'm going to use 5. I'm going to use 5. So the next is to increase my measurements. My bust, like I said earlier, is 36 divided by 4 is going to give me 9 inch and plus how a quarter inch is allowance I added there, so which is here. So I'll go ahead and put 2 inch for the allowance. Then my waist. Waist is 32 divided by 4 is going to give me 8. This is 8. 8 plus this 1 inch that I'm going to cut out is 9. Then 9 plus 2 inch seam allowance. Yeah. So I'm going to connect this to this. Connect this to this. this cloth. I don't know why it's... I hope you can see it clearly. Don't mind it. So that, so before I go ahead and cut, I'm going to add the half inch that I used to join the shoulder, which is somewhere here. Just add a half inch. So that's that. I'll go ahead and cut. If I continue cutting, you know I'm going to join here. So just to be on the safer side, in order to avoid shortage, I'm going to take it up a little bit. If I use one or two, just to be on the safer side. So let me take it up. And then I'll connect for my new handle. Just to be on the safer side, so that you don't get to have a shortage. It's better for you to have overage than shortage. It's better for you to have excess than to have shortage. So that's that. So this is the new armhole. So this is for the back panel. As you can see, I've gone ahead to mark my zip allowance. This is for the zip allowance. So this is my shoulder line. So from my shoulder line to my half cut, 17. So that's that. Remember that my half length is 16.5 plus half inch that we use to join the upper part to the down part, 17. So that's that. So what I'm going to do next is just take my shoulder slope. Like I said, when cutting the front panel, mark 3, then mark 8. That's my shoulder, it's 15 divided by 7.5 plus half inch seam allowance, which is 8. So mark 1 here, I'm going to come down by 1. I'll go ahead, connect it from here to here. Here to here. Then my upper bust is, you know, I used 7, you know, starting here it's 7, so I'm going to mark 7. You know, I came down by 1 inch, so if I should start here, it's going to be 8. Of course, you understand, if you're following my previous video, you should understand this is 8 because I started here, but here, you know, I came down here, so it's going to be 7, but they're all on the same line. Take notes. I hope you understand that simple logic. So that's that. I also come down. Let me mark to know where to come down here. So I'll come down. My bust is 36. 36 divided by 4 is going to give me 9 plus quarter inch for this allowance, which is here. So for the back angle, I'm not going to come inside, I'll just go ahead and curve it. Then for the back neckline, you know the width I use for the front is 5, so I'm going to maintain it. This is 3, I'll just go ahead and measure 2. Add it here, it will be 5. Then for the depth, I'm going to use a depth of, let's say 2. I'm going to use a depth of 2. So I'll go ahead and connect. So that's that. So the next thing is just to my bust spine. My bust spine is 7.5. 7.5 divided by 2 is going to give me 3.75. 3.75 plus 0.5, 4.25. So that's what I'm going to mark here. 4.25. Take note that the 0.5 is for seam allowance. So I'll just go ahead and connect it. Then I'll just connect it to the midpoint of this 8. So I'll just use 4.5. Or let me use 4. Let me just use 4. So that the next is just to take my measurements. Like I said earlier, my bust 36 divided by 4 plus 1/4 inch for his allowance, which is here, which is what I marked earlier, plus 2 inch seam allowance, which is here. Then my take note, I'm starting here to take my measurements. My waist is 32. 32 divided by 4 is going to give me 8. Then plus 2 inch seam allowance is this. So I'll go ahead and connect. So that's that. After that, I'll just go ahead and cut. Don't forget to add your 1/4 inch here, 1/2 inch here for the seam allowance. That's what you use to join the front shoulder to the back shoulder. So this is it. So for the down part of the skirt, it's going to be a full cycle flip with a slit. That's because the zip is going to extend towards there. So that's that. I already had a video tutorial on how to cut a full cycle flip. So you can check it out if you want to know in details how to cut. So that's that. You can see I'm folding it. I folded it. You see, I folded it here. So after folding it, I'll go ahead and fold it again. You can see it. So after folding my fabric, this is what I have. So to get our radius, the waist I'm using is 32. 32 plus 2 for the zip allowance is 34. You know it's going to have a zip at the back. Then 34 divided by 6.28 is going to give us 5.4. So that's what I'm going to mark, 5.4. This is 5.4, somewhere here. So I'm going to mark it round, 5.4. This fabric is, I don't know, it's so much shifting. I hope you can see it. So this is our radius. Then the length of the skirts. The length of this clothes or this fabric is by 60. So the length of my skirt is going to, the actual length of my skirt is going to be 25. But you know, this is going to cut off. So we'll try. It's not even up to 25 watts. Somewhere 24. So I'll just make use of that. That's for the length of the flay. So I'm going to mark 30 around. So that's that. So I'll go ahead and cut. But before I cut, let me just add my seam allowance. I'll add it from the front. Just 0.5 inch. You know, I need a seam allowance to add it to the upper part of the dress. So just 0.5. So this is where I'll cut. Take note that this is just for the seam allowance. This is the actual place, but I added 0.5 for the seam allowance. So that's that. I'll go ahead and cut. So this is it. Remember that our flays, the zip is going to extend towards the down part. So, and there's no opening. So we have to create an opening. So I'll just take one of this and just open it up. So that's that. So this is it. Can see it. So this is it. I'm not going to use a lining. I'm not going to add a lining to it. So I'll just use the fabric to turn it. So that's what I will do. So I'll just use to just, I just folded this. I'm going to place this here. I'm going to place it somewhere here. I'm just trying to make sure that they are equal. So I'm going to use, I'll just measure like 3 inch. That's what I'm going to use. 3 inch. So I'll mark 3 throughout. I'll mark 3 throughout. So this is for the front interfacing, what I used to turn it. So for the back interfacing, I also do the same thing. So for the back interfacing, this is it. You see it? So I'll just place it like this. And cut. So this is for the back interfacing. Then I have to open it up. So that's that. So as you can see, these are fronts. Is the front panel, and this is the interfacing. What I used to turn the neck, you can see it. So I'll just go ahead, join it here, use the interfacing to turn the neck. So this is for the back. This is the back panel, and this is the interfacing. So this is for the back panel, you can see it. Back panel. So, and this is interfacing. I'll join this to this, join this to this, use this to turn the neck. This is attach my zip, then join it to the front panel and then the down part. So, after joining the front panel to the back and the front panel to the back panel, I'll just go ahead and attach this and then hem the mouth, and we are good to go. So, let me go to the sewing machine and do that.
So this is the finished look. You can see how beautiful it is. You can see how full the flay is. I have a detailed tutorial on how I made this sleeve, this exact sleeve. So I'm going to put the link on the description box. So don't forget to like and share with your friends. And for those of us that are yet to subscribe, please kindly click on the subscribe button and hit on the notification bell for you to be notified and make a new upload. So it's like on your way next time with another interesting tutorial. Do have a lovely, lovely day. Bye-bye.